when the linebackers came down and Herb did his job running a good route, getting open, and I gave him the ball and he scored.
You guys gave him any flag after he fumbled at the
linebacker? Well, I mean, we knew coming into the game that they did a good job of getting the ball out. I mean, you see him last year and even this year. You know, they stripped the ball out when the guy's running inside the five or whatever it is about to score. And I mean, that's something we'll learn from, and I hope it never happens again.
They came with the most comfortable you feel throwing the ball over the middle of the field now.
I think it's critical that we take positive strides every game and to continue to improve on our offensive craft.
They came in with the best pass defense in the conference. Well, how are you guys able to kind of pick them apart?
We just went out there and ran our offense and did a decent job of executing. Not our best day. First half was kind of sluggish and sloppy in a way, but we'll take the win.
What do you attribute the first half kind of sluggish to?
It was a slower pace. You know, usually we get out and kind of score really fast, but you know what I mean, it's about execution at the end of the day, and we just have to do the best job we can of doing that.
What's your assessment of the offense 8 games of the season?
We're better than we were the first game, I'll tell you that.
How happy are you to get to a bye week?
We'll enjoy the bye week. We'll enjoy this victory. We'll enjoy the bye week and get ready for our next opponent.
What was practice like this week? Nick talked about the engine not being there all week.
You know, y'all talk about it all the time. You want to keep guys there and in tune and kind of give them the juice to practice with a purpose every time they touch the field. And I think that's just something we're emphasizing now. It's just, okay, we got to go. You know, nothing's guaranteed for us. Regardless of what the rat poison is, you know, what's going on, we have to go play because we know we have to go play and we can lose at any time.
Y'all threw on first down quite often. Was there a concerted effort to move the ball through the air?
Y'all all just left, so I must have got what y'all wanted, I guess. What was your question?
Jalen, you threw on first down quite often. Was that concerted effort this week to throw more and kind of
pass it? No, it was just there. I mean, that's just kind of how it kind of played out. And you know, regardless of what coach calls, we got to execute it.
Jalen, what was the conversation like at halftime after the first half start?
We didn't play like we wanted to play. You know, we wanted to really dominate it. And I mean, yeah, we scored 21 points, but you know, it wasn't our type of football. You know, and we kind of turned it up when we came back in the second half.
Did you notice all the cigars being lit up by the fans?
Yeah, I saw the smoke and I could smell it.
Pretty thick, huh?
Yeah.
It's a simple question, but when your run game is so good, what is the play action helping for this offense?
When you run a ball and kind of create a threat, you know, for their defense, the secondary, and even their force in the front seven, that's always beneficial for us, knowing that we can drop back and run a play action or a naked or whatever it is, so it always helps us.
You can be really comfortable in a naked. Is that one of your favorite plays?
It's a play that, you know, we just try to execute just like the others.
Yeah.
What's y'all's goal for the open week? Because it's not like you get it totally off.
Just continue to prepare for the team you have in front of us. And we got to continue to get better. We need to polish up on what we messed up on and just continue to improve and get ready. The season's not over.
You visited with Kadir Talloway after the game. What's that conversation like?
It was a pleasure to meet him. I mean, that's kind of set it off, set it stone for African-American quarterbacks, and pleasure to meet him.
So you knew who he was.
Coach gave us his assessment through the first 8 games. How about you? How you guys have done? Where you still need to go?
What did Coach say?
He thought you guys still had work to do.
I do too. That's how I feel.
What happened?
What is the sequence in the second quarter when you guys got down the goal line and had 4 or 5 plays?
What happened?
The sequence in the second quarter when you guys got down near the goal line and had 4 or 5 plays there. What was
we had a false start and it was just kind of sloppy play, but we got in, so we're happy with it.
What do you hear about the rivalry like around campus, students, Tennessee Week, and what have you learned about it?
Well, I mean, I went to class the other day, maybe Thursday, and as we're leaving class, you know, the professor says, it's Tennessee Hate Week, and I just start smiling and kind of walk out of class. But I mean, it's a big thing here, and I'm happy for the fans, I'm happy for this team, of course, and just the whole Crimson Tide family, because, you know, we got this win today.
When you inherit a winning streak of survival, is there some responsibility to keep it open?
We want to win every game we play. You know, yeah, this is a rivalry, but I mean, you know, we can't just be up because it's a rivalry game. We have to be up because it's Saturday and you have to go play.
Coach Abel was talking about some come to Jesus meeting this week that he felt the need to have. He was talking about wanting to create tension. I think it was like Wednesday in practice, just based on practicing on like Monday and Tuesday. Wait, what was said in the come to Jesus meeting, and what exactly was created?
You know, here we have a lot of come to Jesus meetings. And when he feels something needs to be addressed, he addresses it, and we respond. So he's gonna continue to do that. That'll never change.
So what was different about Wednesday's practice compared to Monday and Tuesday?
The whole idea is to come out there and have intensity and do our job and do it with a kind of fire in our eyes. And we just need to continue to do that and improve every week.
I'm sorry if you've been asked, but how'd you see Tua sort of respond after he threw that interception?
Tua, you know, just like the fumble I had my freshman year, you know, the first play of college football for me, fumble it and all that, and come back to the sideline, straight face, I'm good, coach. Tua kind of had that same face that I had. I mean, that's a good thing for him. That's good.
Satan says he's apologetic.
Thanks, John. No problem.